He knew enough now, he thought. All these truths tumbling around each other in his head. There must be a way to puzzle the pieces together. If he used everything he knew, he could discover a new path to destiny. The book's pages fluttered to the beginning once again, faster than before, and he fell. The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky Ripper had surfaced. Renata knew that using it could go catastrophically wrong, but he was sure he could figure out how to use it safely. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis Stone was hidden there. It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it, to take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course, Renato had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion, and he had a gut feeling that he needed to use that to his advantage. Renato finally realized that Lupino was a traitor to the cause, and maybe Renato could use that somehow. Renato couldn't quite put his paw on when he'd realized Lupino was working for the Empire. He'd never exactly seen Lupino sending coded messages to the palace, but he was sure. The rabbit had been on too many disastrous missions where he was the only survivor, or where he accidentally missed getting on the boat that went down to the abyss in flames. If Renato could prevent Lupino from getting back to the fleet with all the intelligence he'd probably gathered, it might be worth the trip. How had they come to this? They'd been on so many adventures together. Lupino had talked Renato out of prison at least 4 times, and Renato had rescued Lupino from at least 2 lynch mobs. Resented him? Lupino was hilarious because he was so down on himself and everyone else. But behind the laughs, he wasn't a happy camper. Ooh, was this payback? Or did the Empire have his little white tail in a vice? Ravens were landing everywhere from dropships. He'd better get moving. If they got to Lupino first, the rabbit would give the Empire all the intelligence he'd been stealing from the Rebellion, and they'd probably give him a medal. He'd have to be very careful about how he played Lupino. At the slightest hint of danger, the mad rabbit would take off like a... well, a rabbit. Bloody and exhausted, Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing shuffling his favorite deck. Now that he knew what the rabbit was, there are a few things about him that Renato didn't find so amusing anymore. You sent me an urgent message saying that you're in danger.
Oh, I am. The ravens are coming. Now, I've got a clever plan to kidnap Zenobia.
Renato wanted to clap shackles on the rabbit and shout, "You're a traitor, and I'm not falling for it." But if there was one thing Renato was sure of, it was that the core of the Sky River was dangerous mostly to its user. If he could put it in the Emperor's hands, old Isengrim III might blow himself and his fleet up with it. Yes, that was it. Renato felt like a real hero. Brave and smart. He told the rabbit all about the Sky Ripper's God's Eye core.
"I'll go get the core while you attack Zenobia,"
he told the rabbit.
"Wait, I've an even better idea. I'll get the core and you attack Zenobia," said the rabbit.
"Right, yeah, that is better," agreed Renato. Perfect. The traitor would make sure the Emperor got the core. Now Renato just needed the Emperor to use the core. If he could only get something that the Emperor wanted very badly. Zenobia. He could save her and bait the Emperor at the same time. Right. Now, all Renato had to do was fight his way through Zenobia's invading troops, sneak onto her ship and into her bedroom, and kidnap her without any of her dozens of guards alerting her. Then, he would rely on her love for him to convince her how evil her father was, so she'd run away with him instead of going back to her father, who was going to blow himself up. It did sound a little risky. But Renato had a feeling it would work out somehow. It always did. "Don't look down," he thought. If I craft a sword now, it's going to be really short. Who are you looking at? Oh, right. No one. Renato was halfway to Zenobia's encampment when Lupino showed up. He was disheveled and distraught.
They jumped us. I barely got away. Oh, they got the core.
Oh, it was all going according to plan, thought Renato. Now he just needed Zenobia on his side. Yes, that was even better. The Iblis Stone. Zenobia could get it. And then the Emperor would have to pursue them. Wait. No. The gem would corrupt anyone, even her. That's it, he thought. Even Lupino. Even though Lupino was already a traitor, it would turn him against his secret master, the Emperor. He would try to make himself Emperor. And the Emperor would have to defend himself with the core. Boom. He was a super genius. This is terrible, Renato told the rabbit. If only I had gone for the Iblis Stone. But now it's lost in enemy territory. He handed Lupino a map. It gives the bearer so much power. We can only hope the Emperor never finds it.
What was that? Said Lupino. I think someone's following us.
I didn't hear anything.
Rabbit ears. You go on ahead. I'll check it out.
And with that, Lupino hopped off with the map. Ooh, wouldn't this gauntlet look swell with that jewel in it? Renato slinked through Zenobia's ship, making no sound at all. She was curled up on her bed. He'd forgotten how beautiful she was, how sleek, how soft. He tapped her on the shoulder with his sword. She was made of smoke, and he noticed he had a very solid blade to his throat. Did you really think you could capture me? Purred a familiar voice. I just wanted to chat. Said Renato. Did you ever wonder why the Emperor adopted you? He needs a sacrifice. Someone who truly loves him to make a bargain with the lost gods.
That's a vicious lie. He wants to bring them back. That's crazy. Why would anyone...
They could make him immortal. An eater of souls. And with that, her eyes widened. She understood. Renato told her how he had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred, how he had slept in a burnt village. At midnight, the Emperor's victims had come to him in his dreams to tell him of the hideous eldritch rituals they'd been sacrificed in. He could still see those kittens and puppies, their wide, sad eyes, their moist noses.
You can't prove that.
I've got a witness at the observatory. He couldn't tell her, not yet, why he was really here. He didn't want her to be anywhere near the fleet when her father blew himself and Lupino up. So he told her about how the Emperor's obscene rituals had raised ancient artifacts out of the land. how he'd followed the appalling trail of the hideous horrors His Majesty had perpetrated for the sake of his own immortality. "Any of this ring a bell?" he said.
"He told me it was all lies."
"You've always known when I was lying. I always hated that about you," said Renardo. The rebellion had started after atrocities that the Empire hushed up. Renardo had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred for one book. He had slept in a burnt village. Dead kittens and puppies had come to tell him what the Emperor had done to them.
"I'd know if my father started practicing black magic."
"Why? Would you join in?"
"No. I'd destroy his books and I'd..."
"Oh, God. Okay. You're not completely wrong. They've resurrected one of his victims. Well, look, I mean, look, it's not exactly alive, but it can talk. A true witness," she said. "These platforms are great. Renardo wanted one for his house." The observatory was a burning hulk. Dead scientists and black feathers everywhere. The Ravens had taken special care to burn the reanimated witness to cinders. Zenobia stared at the carnage. He didn't want me to hear the witness, did he? I guess not. What's your plan? She asked.
So, Renato explained his brilliant gambit. Sending Lupino to get the Iblis Stone, become super powerful and corrupted, provoke the Emperor into using the core against him, thus blowing up both of them, and hopefully the fleet too.
Let me visit your council, she said, shaken. I want to help.
Could he really trust her? He'd made Zenobia see how evil her father really was. He wished she didn't feel this urge to join in the rebellion. After all, he'd taken care of the Emperor, right? Yeah, but she'd always been conscientious like that. She told him she had to go somewhere first. So Renato gave her the location of the secret base and they agreed to meet in the ruins. He had a very good feeling about this. What had Zenobia gone off to do? What was more important than meeting the Rebel Council? Had he made a mistake, sending her to the ruins? No. He knew they could trust each other. He could trust her because she never broke her word. And she could trust him because she could see right through him. Well, she'd probably be there well before him. She at least didn't have to fight her way through rainstorms of ravens.
His friend is a swan. Could he join up? He dyes his feathers.
As he came around the bend, there was Lupino, unconscious on the side of the path. And Renato could smell a familiar, sweet, smoky scent. Who? Zenobia. It had to be. She never used a combat spell when she could use drowsy gas. That meant she had the Iblis Stone. What would it do to her? She hated her father now. She'd kill him for sure. The Council wouldn't mind if she killed the Emperor, but murdering her father would destroy her. He had to get to whatever ledge she was on and talk her down from it.
For a moment, Renato wished that somebody had been watching.